great to see you. Good feeling the love out there for
Tyler?
Yes,
yes, yes. I love it, man. I love it.
Welcome back. You look fantastic. How's everything going? How's the baby boy?
He's good. He's good. You can't tell what happened to me, though, right?
Did something happen? What happened?
Well, I have to be really careful because I got to get a better, diverse group of friends because most of my friends are black.
Uh-huh.
And what happened was I was shooting this movie and one of the black guys who works at DP was just like, you know, we're going to take the windshield out of the car because we want to make sure he's a friend of mine. We want to make sure we can get the camera in. I'm just like, okay, great. So it's like 10 below and we're out driving without a windshield and I burn my face and my lips and everything.
Yeah,
and I come back in the house, into the trailer, and my makeup artist, Loretta, she goes, what happened to your lips? I'm like, what are you talking about? And your face. I'm like, what's going on? She's like, you been smoking weed? I was like, I'm like, no, I don't smoke weed, I chew it. So I say this to all the black people, they're like, what happened to him, what's wrong? Then my white friends go, oh, that's windburn. I'm like, how do you know? Like, we ski, we know. My white friends ski, my black friends don't ski, so they didn't know what windburn was. I never heard a windburn in my life.
Yeah.
I mean, I barely wear suntan lotion. I don't even know. You know, I'm just like, what is this? But yeah, I'm better now. But yeah, it was pretty bad.
Yeah, well, you look fantastic.
You whoever told me, though.
I'm sorry. Okay, you got to text me next time. Yeah.
That's right. Like, what is happening right now?
How is the little boy? How's your
baby? He's amazing. He's amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's nine years old now. And it's a good age because now, you know, we have really good conversations. But when he was six, he asked for my credit card. He's like, because we went to a toy store and I bought something with a credit card. He didn't know what a credit card was. Like, can I have your credit card? I'm like, oh, well, son, no, now he's nine. He can fill out an application, so we're good.
Yeah, we're good now. Yeah, hey, no, this is real money, bud.
This is real money. You got a good job, buddy.
I want to ask you about this because I see you post that you've been to like a bunch of concerts. Do you like going to concerts?
Oh, I love it. Yeah, unfortunately, during the strike, I had a lot of time on my hands. So
Yeah, exactly.
So I went on tour with Beyonce. Yeah. Yeah, she didn't know it. She didn't know.
Oh, okay.
No,
all right.
She didn't know it, but I was on tour. I was on tour with her. All these different stops.
And, yeah. You know,
She's amazing. She's amazing, man. But I played that Renaissance album so much, I had to put Beyonce on mute. I was like, I can't listen another.
You need a little Beyonce break?
Yeah, I needed a break because if you wake up in the morning saying, you know, all the songs early in the morning, all day long, it's like, and then she comes out with some other great stuff a couple of days ago.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, it's a whole new thing.
Yeah. So it's good. It's good. Now, Chris Stapleton. I went to see Chris Stapleton, who's amazing. Yeah, Diana Ross, Janet Jackson. Man, I went to all the concerts.
You did all that?
I was on tour with everybody. They didn't know it, though. They didn't know it.
I want to talk to you about Madea because we love the movie.
Why do we always have to talk about that broad, man?
Because I tell you why. I love Madea. We love Madea.
Yeah.
It's genius. It's genius and it's funny.
Yeah.
And people want to know, will we ever get to see another Madea movie?
If the world keeps going crazy, yes. I think we need fun, man. That's why I love watching your show. You know, just something to lift us. There's so much weight in the world right now. So yeah, speaking of weight, she'll be back. She's really heavy. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, okay, all right. So maybe something.
Maybe something, okay. Maybe something, yeah.
You're one of the most prolific producers that I know. And we were talking, you got to meet a legendary producer, Norman Lear.
Norman Lear,
And got to, who passed away, sadly, but...
At 100 years old, though.
100.
Yeah, I don't know how sad that is, though. At 100 years old, that means you've lived an amazing life.
Yeah.
And he did so much so many amazing things, and he brought so much joy and laughter, and he was such an inspiration to me. So getting to know him was a huge gift to me.
Yeah. I saw you on... Yeah. I saw you with Robin Roberts, what were you doing, Tuskegee?
He was in World War II.
Yeah.
And we were talking, he was saying, you know, I would love to be able to, if there's any of those guys still around, I'd love to be able to say thank you. So I told Robin Roberts that we were on GMA, and she's like, I can make that happen. So, because her father was a Tuskegee Airman. And so she got the chance to put the Tuskegee Airmen that are still around in touch with Norman Lear so that he could thank them. I thought that was amazing.
Come on, that was absolutely the best.
Pretty awesome. Yeah.
Also, in the way to give back to a guy that's given so much.
Given so much, and he told all of them about windburn.
See, Why people got to tell everyone what's going on?
Tell everybody, please. Everybody.
Well, let's talk about your new movie, okay?
Yes.
Mea Culpa.
Yeah.
This is written and directed by you. This is a thriller.
Yeah.
And what made you want to do this?
Oh, I love that genre. You remember all those movies from the 80s and 90s with Glenn Close and all those the thrillers? And my mother would be sitting there at the television like this, calling her cousin's sister's girlfriend, you got to see this movie.
Yeah.
So I wanted to do something like that. And I think I did it.
You did it.
I think I did it.
Yeah.
It's sexy.
Oh, it is. There's twists and turns.
Twists and turns.
And then there's very sexy.
It's very sexy.
The paint scene, yeah.
People will be talking about the paint scene. Everybody going to want a paint set after they see this.
Yeah, you want paint remover as well.
Paint remover, that's right. Listen to me. This is not Netflix and chill with your kids. This is an adult movie. Yeah. I wish it was out now for Valentine's Day because there'd be a lot of paint spilled.
Yeah, a lot of.
Can you imagine though trying to have to clean up that paint? All the places it would go. But when you see the movie, you know what I'm talking about.
Does it get awkward when you direct a scene like that?
No, listen. I've got Kelly Rowland, who is the lead in the movie, who's phenomenal. She's phenomenal. So proud of her.
I love
Kelly.
She's
the lead. She killed it. And Trevante Rhodes, and they played this cat and mouse thing in this. Somebody said, "Ooh, yeah." They play this cat and mouse thing that's really, really sexy. But I have it's so not what people think. Like if you see a sex scene, you go, "Oh, that was so hot." If you're there on set, you'd be like, "No," because the intimacy coordinator works with all my actors and actresses to make sure that they're comfortable before they even come to set. Like what works, what doesn't work, right? And then I had this great scene. It's beautiful. You see it in the movie. It's a beautiful scene. At the end of that paint scene, the camera's coming up, and I'm holding on it because it's so perfect. And Trevante and Kelly, they're there, embrace, and he goes, "Hey, man, this paint is cold. Cut."
I want to show a clip. This is not that scene. No, I can't show that scene. No.
No. No, you have FCC issues. Yeah, you don't want to show that.
Here's a scene from Tyler Perry's Mea Culpa. Take a look at this.
Doesn't matter what I think. It's what the jury thinks.
So I tell you that I'm attracted to you, and you start throwing all this in my face. I think I need a new lawyer, because everything in your body says you're attracted to me, but you won't admit it to yourself or to me. I can't trust you. New lawyer.
If that's what you want to do, but I'll just say this. Your trial is in a month. And that'll be hard for any attorney to get up to speed in such short time.
Admit it. You find me attractive.
That is a lie. I'm here to try to help you.
Lying to me isn't helping me, Mia.
Woo! Tyler Perry, everybody. Mea Culpa premieres February 23rd on Netflix. Hillary Swank joins us after the break. Stick around, everybody. Hey, hey.